So, your uncle. What's wrong with him?
He's possessed.
As in the devil?
Something like that. He says a dark man is following him, watching him at all times.
What do you make of it?
It's nonsense, of course. But I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me. You see, it runs in my family.
Possession?
No, Detective. Deteriorating melancholy. Practically every member of the Hartwood family is driven mad before they grow old.
But Jeremy didn't kill himself. Is that why he's at your setup?
Despite being convinced that he is truly possessed, he decided to put his last chips on Dr. Gray and his psychoanalysis, figuring he might stumble upon some cure.
You mentioned a letter.
I received a disturbing letter from Jeremy accusing the staff and all the other patients of being involved in some cult. And now they are also out to get him.
Could it be real? Or is it all just in his head?
It's a story he tells himself, Mr. Carnby. Anything to avoid the truth.
Which is?
That we're all terribly insignificant. That people mean so very little to one another. That there is no one out to get Jeremy Hartwood because he isn't worth getting.
Here we are.
My uncle's not well, Mr. Carnby. I want to make sure he's all right.
Then what's my part in this? You couldn't get a cab?
I just wouldn't feel safe going alone. Did you bring a gun?
Yeah. You think it'll actually come to that?
No. But you might need to wave it around depending on how agreeable the staff will be.
What exactly are we gonna do when we find Jeremy?
I don't know. Let's just find him first.
Hello?
It's so quiet. Where is everyone?
This is a big place. Maybe they're on the other side of the house.
Stay here. I'll have a look.
Surprised by her own...
Thank you. think I'll be able to get in there.
Every day, your silence weighs a little.
Please do not touch the boiler.
Sunday, June 22nd.
I need the key.
wait. Don't.
Excuse me? Do you know where I can find Jeremy Hartwood?
Well, of course not.
McCarthy, what are you doing? I told you not to lose sight of the girl.
Don't you worry, Mags. I'll find that little rascal.
Who are you people? What are you doing here?
I'm sorry about all this, but I'm looking for my uncle. His name is Jeremy Hartwood.
What are you doing, child? You shouldn't be alone. Go find McCarthy.
Who are you? Are you here for the Fay Dodo?
Go upstairs now.
My name is Emily Hartwood. I'm the niece of Jeremy Hartwood. This is Detective Carnby.
The police? Why are you here?
No, I'm a private investigator. Sorry to bother you. My client's worried about her uncle. He's a patient here at Dorsetto. If you don't mind, could you direct us where to find him?
No, I can't. Jeremy has gone missing. If you leave your information, I will make sure to contact you.
Wait, he ran away?
No, he won't leave the house. He's around here somewhere, and both of our orderlies are looking for him.
That's unacceptable. Where's Dr. Gray? I want to speak with him immediately.
Fine. I'll ask him. Wait here and don't touch anything.
Do you want to see Jeremy's room?
Can you show us?
Follow me.
Thank you. Strange kid.
Let's look around, see what we can find.
Every night the dark man stands.
Have you ever seen anything like this? Looks like a talisman.
You mean like this one?
Can you find me a knife to cut the canvas? I want to take this with me.
You want to take the painting? Sure, I'll find one.
I found this tube as well. Should keep it safe for you. Do you want to carry it or should I? Miss Hartwood. Emily?
I'll take it. Thank you.
We're done here, right?
I'm not sure. I don't know how to do any of this.
Listen, I think we should talk to Dr. Gray. He must know something about what's going on around here.
Okay. Let's do that.
Come on, I don't want to be here all night.
Detective Carnby? Where did... this place.